One of the biggest evacuations in U.S. history underway right now in Florida. One of the biggest in U.S. history. I want to bring in now Randy Tell. He is a resident of the Keys and a business owner. And he and his family say they're going to stay put, at least for now. And he joins me by phone. Hey, Randy, so glad you could join us this evening. Did you happen to hear my interview with the mayor earlier?
I did. It was pretty interesting, and he's not too far off, but you know, if you're in a mobile home or you're staying on an ocean front house or a condo, I can understand. A lot of the houses here are built very, very well, poured concrete, and they're on high ground. They're on closer to the bay. And, you know, it's one of those things. It's still unpredictable. It could go west of us. And, you know, remember, Key West is about 80 miles from Isla Mirada, where I'm at. And that could make a big difference on the winds and the surge.
Randy, I think you're a very smart guy, and I understand what you're saying. And you have your family there with you, right? And I mean, listen, I don't mean to come down on you, but wouldn't it be better if you just left, just in case you left? I mean, what harm would it be for you and your family just to get to safety, just in case, because you don't know with these situations.
Well, very true. You know, I have three daughters. They all spent 2 days on the phone looking for accommodations for everybody so we could be together with five dogs. And we weren't coming up with much. And as we watched this storm the last few days, it would move east, it would move west, it would move here, it would move there. And the last thing that I really want to do after experience Hurricane Andrew is leave somewhere and end up in ground zero somewhere else. So it's very difficult to run from a hurricane, and they have a pretty good idea where it's going now, but 40 or 50 miles left or right can make a big difference.
I know that, Randy, but you're in ground zero right now. Where you are is ground zero.
Well, we are certainly in the upper part of the Keys, not the Key West area, which and lower Keys that they're predicting this is going to go, but it's one of those things that you just have to hunker down. You have to get everything together. You know, everybody, we've all agreed on this is going to be the best thing that we can do, be together, and you know, we're ready to take it on with everything we have. And you know, I've seen it before, my friends have seen it before. There's quite a few. The last time I checked, there's about 400 of us in the Upper Keys that are staying.
Okay. All right. Again, I don't mean to beat you up, okay? I'm not doing that at all. I'm just really worried about you, having listened to the forecast and the forecasters and looking at, can we put this, do you have television now, Randy?
Oh, of course. I've been watching it all day.
In a perfect world,
we would evacuated and we would be sitting in Vegas right now. and having a good time. But, you know, the reality of things sometimes doesn't always work out the way you want it to.
Right.
And sometimes you just have to keep it simple and hope for the best. I mean, really, there's not a lot you can do with this storm. And if you look where it's going in South Florida, although it looks better on the East Coast right now than the West Coast, and that was the opposite a day ago, you just never know.
So that's your final decision. You're not going to wake up tomorrow at 5 a.m. and say, you know what, we're going to go. That's it. You're going to stay, right?
No, we're staying. We're hunkering down.
Gotcha.
We're in a very secure house on high ground, and we're ready to face what's coming.
All right, Randy. You guys be safe. Thank you so much, okay? We'll be thinking about you, and we'll check back with you, all right?
You're welcome.
All right,
thank you.
Thank you.